वेलकम टू ज्योग्राफी क्लास।
हैव यू एवर बीन टू अ फॉरेस्ट फॉर अ पिकनिक? यू माइट हैव श्योरली गॉन टू अ पार्क इफ यू लिव इन अ सिटी, बट इफ यू लिव इन अ विलेज यू हैव डेफिनेटली गॉन टू अ कल्टिवेबल लैंड और एनी ऑर्चर्ड। बट हाउ डू यू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन द नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड द प्लांटेड वेजिटेशन? The same variety may be found growing wild in the forest under natural condition, and the same tree may be the planted in your garden under human supervision. So, you have to know, natural vegetation refers to a plant community that has been left undisturbed over a long period of time. The plant community that adapted themselves to a particular physical conditions and without any human interference is called natural vegetation. In this video, we are quickly going to learn about different types of forest that exist in India. As you know, India is a tropical country. The mainland stretches from 8°4′ north to 37°6′ north. The Tropic of Cancer divides the India into two equal parts. Now, we are also aware of the fact, as we go away from the equator towards pole, temperature as well as rainfall decreases. The reason for this phenomenon is the incoming solar radiation. At the equator, the sun rays are the most direct on the earth. But as you move towards pole, the sun's angle on the sky decreases, and as a result, incoming solar intensity also reduces. The total length of India from north to south, it is about 3,214 km. This huge latitudinal variation keeps tremendous effect on the climate from warm Kanyakumari to cold Kashmir. Now, temperature and rainfall are the important determinants of the climate that affect the distribution of natural vegetation. On the basis of some certain features such as predominant vegetation type and climatic regions, Indian forest can be divided into the following groups. First one is the tropical evergreen forest. Carefully check the word tropical. It means tropical region. Now, which one is this place? Wait, this region is on the world map. And this is on the map of India. Secondly, the word evergreen means green leaves throughout the year. Now say it all together, tropical evergreen forest. This forest remain green throughout the year and they exist in the tropical region in India. So we can say, this forest are found in the western slopes of the Western Ghat, then hills of the northeastern region and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Here you have to remember, the mean annual temperature should be
25°C to 27°C
and annual rainfall should be over 200 cm. So we can say, tropical evergreen forests are found in the windward side of the mountain like Western Ghat and the Purvanchal Range, or in the warm and humid areas. We already know that windward side of the mountains affected by the high amount of rainfall due to the orographic effect, and the tropical regions are also affected by the convectional rainfall. And remember one thing, high amount of rainfall promotes the vegetation growth. So the trees in the tropical forest are dense, tall and green. Now let's observe the forest structure of the tropical evergreen forest. If you see the ground level, you will find shrubs and creeper plants. After that, you will find short trees of around 20 to 30 meters height, and then comes the tall trees which grow about 60 meters high above the ground. These trees are tall because there is a competition among the trees and plants of the tropical forest for sunlight. The taller ones enjoy the maximum amount of sunlight. They constantly struggle and fight to grow taller so that they can have the maximum sunlight. Usually, the uppermost branches of the trees act as an umbrella, which looks like a canopy, and this canopy do not allow sunlight to reach the ground. Leaves of the tropical trees that are broad, long, and have a narrow ending. The shape of the leaves helps the raindrops to run off quickly, because if that doesn't happen, then there will be fungus and bacteria on the leaves due to the warm temperature. There is no definite time for the trees to shed their leaves. That's why forests appear green throughout the year. Trees found in this forest include rosewood, mahogany, ebony, etc. Ebony creates very dense canopy, which is impenetrable for sunlight. Rosewood is found in impure stands. Mahogany is inaccessible forest belt due to the dense growth. The British were aware of the economic value of this forest in India. Forests were also cleared for introducing plantation of tea, rubber, and coffee. Next, we are going to start tropical deciduous forest. Let's look at the word tropical, which means yes, tropical region, and deciduous means any plant, tree or shrub that shed their leaves in a particular period of time. These are the most widespread forest in India. These forests are also found in the humid areas of the subtropical region. Now, these forests are also known as monsoon forest, because the trees in the forest shed their leaves during the dry season. Again, they regrow during monsoon season in India. Now the question is, why tropical deciduous trees shed their leaves? And the answer is to prevent excess loss of water via transpiration. Tropical deciduous trees usually composed of large and broad leaves. When water is plentiful, the trees take up water. The large leaves take the sunlight to photosynthesis food, and the excess water is removed through the leaves via transpiration. During dry seasons, when water is scarce, it becomes a necessity to conserve the water that is available. That's the reason leaves are shed off to limit transpiration. They spread over the regions which receive rainfall between
100 to 200 cm.
Teak, sal, shisham, hura, mahua, amla, simul, kusum, and sandalwood are the main trees of this forest. This forest have suffered from overgrazing, forest fire, and large proportion of this forest have been cleared for the agricultural purposes. Now, tell me one thing, why there is very low or no forest cover found in the Indo-Gangetic Plains? Here, you have to remember one thing, the plains of northern India are densely populated. That has led to the deforestation of the tropical deciduous trees on a vast extent. Or we can say, especially for the clearance of land for urbanization, expansion of agriculture, and building transport infrastructure, etc. That's why the Indo-Gangetic Plains or the Northern Plains are not covered by the dense vegetation. Now, let's move to the thorny vegetation. So basically here you will find thorny shrubs and bushy trees. You will even find a few tall trees. This kind of vegetation occurs in the areas that receive rainfall less than 50 cm. So you can imagine that there is a less rainfall. The roots of the trees are long and most of the water is stored. Since we know that these forests are found at a location with rainfall is less than 50 cm, that means the place can also called as a semi-arid areas. These forests are found in the areas of Southwest Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh. They are also found on the lower side of the Western Ghats, covering large areas of Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh. Here you have to remember one thing, they are basically the leeward side of Western Ghat. Now, some common trees found in this forest are babul, wild teat palm, neem, etc. At the end, we can say it is not going to be much greenery. Leaves are thorny in nature. However, I'm not saying that the trees of this forest don't have any leaves at all. The leaves are few and very small in size. The trees remain leafless for the most part of the year. That's how it looks like a shrub vegetation. Now we are going to discuss about the mountain vegetation. From the word mountain, you can easily understand it refers to the mountainous region. Mountain means land with higher elevation. You are familiar with the word normal lapse rate. It means when altitude increases, temperature decreases. With change in temperature, there will be a change in natural vegetation. Now, if you get a map of India, can you guess where the mountains are? Yes, in mainland India, you will find the mountains in the northern part. Here I am talking about Himalayas. It stretches from the northwest to the northeastern part of India. If you remember the Himalayan mountains, they are divided into three ranges. They are Himadri, which is the greater Himalaya. Then comes Himachal, which is the middle Himalayas. Then comes Shivalik Himalayas, that is the lower Himalayas. The width as well as their altitude can vary from 900 meters to 8000 meters above sea level. That means as we go from the foothills of Himalayas towards higher ranges, temperature drops, and that has a direct effect on the natural vegetation. Himalayan vegetation varies according to the altitude and the climatic conditions.
So, the lower foothills have deciduous forest, the middle slopes have mixed deciduous and coniferous forest. Grass grows on very high slopes. Kindly remember, coniferous forest have soft wood evergreen trees.
Now, the last one is
mangrove or tidal forest. These forests are generally found in deltas of all major rivers
and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Please remember one thing, mangroves grow along the coast in the salty or marshy land, especially in the tidal creeks, mud flats and estuaries. This forest have various salt absorbing trees. Their roots are deep and submerged in water. Palm, coconut, sundari are the main trees found in this type of vegetation. That's all about the natural vegetation in India.
I hope this video is informative for you. So, stay happy, stay safe. I'm going to meet you very soon. Bye.